Jesus, he's the one who came up with the salvation through Jesus dying on the cross. All these were introduced by this guy Paul, who was originally a Jew. And in Islam, there was Abdullah ibn Sabah, who entered into Islam in order to destroy Islam through the same methodology. Through Shia. So it's much more serious than what we think. So, هذا الرجل عبد الله بن سبأ قال لعلي بن أبي طالب أنت الله حقا. This man عبد الله told Ali, you are Allah in truth. وعلي بن طالب لا يرضى أن أحدا ينزله فوق منزلته هو حتى إنه رضي الله عنه من إنصافه وعدله وعلمه وخبرته كما يقول على منبر الكوفة خير هذه الأمة بعد نبيها أبو بكر ثم عمر. He said, and verily Ali, may Allah be pleased with him, will not be satisfied that anyone will give him a position above the one that he deserves, above his real position, which is the servant of Allah. And because of his extreme justice and fairness and his knowledge and his experience, he would say on the minbar, when he would give the khutbah in Al-Kufa, he would say, verily, the best of this nation after its messenger is Umar, is Abu Bakr, then Umar.
Ali himself
used to say that. Now you tell this to the Shia, it will come from this ear and go from this one. They don't want to keep it inside. They will reject it. They say, no, this is not a hadith. Although this has been established that he used to say that. Because if he said that, then that will destroy their whole religion. Anyways, يُعلن ذلك في الخطبة, announcing this during the khutbah. وقد تواتر النقل عنه بذلك رضي الله عنه. Tawatur, they say a hadith mutawatir is one, if I remember correctly, one more than 10 companions, one has been received from more than 10 narrators. يعني when you say hadith mutawatir, meaning there's no doubt in its authenticity, because so many different people have narrated the same hadith. So this particular statement of Ali has been narrated by a large number of companions for a long time.
Tawatur,
mutawatir.
Mutawatir.
The hadith mutawatir. Meaning, so many people narrated this hadith that no way all of them are going to make a mistake. You understand what I'm saying?
Authentic.
أيوة. والذي يقول هكذا ويقر بالفضل لأهله من البشر كيف يرضى أن يقول له قائل إنك أنت الله. And the one who says this and he admits about the virtue of the people among the of the humans among the people like Abu Bakr, he would admit the virtue of Abu Bakr and the virtue of Umar, how would we accept that a person tells them you are Allah in truth? ولهذا عزرهم أبشع تعزير. This is why he punished them in the most severe punishment. أمر بالأخاديد فخدت ثم ملئت حطبا وأوقدت ثم أتى بهؤلاء فقذفهم في النار وأحرقهم بها. He called for trenches, يرحمك الله, for trenches to be built. Then he commanded that they get some wood. Then they lit the wood, then he threw them in there. And he burnt them. And the Shaykh said, لِأَنَّ فِرْيَتُهُمْ عَظِيمَ وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ وَلَيْسَتْ هَيْنًا. Because their claim was outrageous. We seek refuge in Allah. It wasn't something simple. It wasn't a minor innovation. This is someone telling a human being, you are Allah in truth. نسأل الله العافية. ويقال إن عبد الله بن سبأ هرب ولم يمسكوه. And it was said that this guy Abdullah ibn Sabah, who started the whole thing, was able to escape, and they did not catch him. المهم, he says the important thing, أن علي بن أبي طالب, أن علي بن أبي طالب رضي الله عنه أحرق السبائية بالنار لأنهم ادعوا فيه الألوهية. The important thing is Ali, may Allah have mercy on him, and may Allah be pleased with him, he burnt them, the Sabaiyya, those who they were called Sabaiyya because Abdullah ibn Sabah. Aywa. This is very common that according to a man, the group will be called after him. Right. So like Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, they call him Wahhabis. This is also from the misguidance of these people. فَلَقُولْ, because Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab rahimahullah was a shaykh who established the tawheed after people started worshipping graves besides Allah. That those who love to worship the graves, they give bad titles about Shaykh Muhammad ibn Wahhab to scare the people away. If read his book, it's قَالَ اللَّهُ قَالَ رَسُولُ. Allah said, the messenger said, don't worship none but Allah. Allah is the only true God. Don't seek no help from someone in the grave, and so forth. But in other countries, they have a very bad advertisement against him in order to keep the people away from that. So anytime you say La ilaha illallah and you deal with Tawheed, you say you Wahhabi, you Wahhabi. Especially if you go back home, they don't want to hear that stuff. They want to go to the grave of Maulana, I don't know, Farfur, Farafiri, so they could ask him for chicken and rice. Yeah, Sufiya and anyone else. Allahumma musta'an. Anywho, the Shaykh said, فنقول كل من كان من أهل القبلة لا ينكرون هذين النوعين من التوحيد، وهما توحيد الربوبية وتوحيد الألوهية. وإن كان يوجد من بعض أهل البدع من يؤله أحد من البشر. So we say all those who turn towards the قبلة, يعني all those who are Muslims, they do not deny the two kinds of توحيد, ربوبية and ألوهية. Even though they may be some among the people of innovation who claim that someone else is a god, like also the Ahmadiyya, who said that the Ghulam Ahmad was also a prophet, and some of them said that he was God. In America, the Nation of Islam, the group of Nation of Islam, they said that their, what was his name?
Elijah
Muhammad. They said that he was a God, and he lives in a spaceship. Some crazy stuff. You heard that? Allah musta'an. Anyways. لكن الذي كثر فيه النزاع بين أهل القبلة هو القسم الثالث وهو توحيد الأسماء والصفات. He said, but really the thing that there's a lot of dispute and difference about, يعني regarding within the Muslims, is the third kind of tawheed, the tawheed of the names and the attributes of Allah. This is where we clash. We agree Allah is the only creator, we agree that only Allah deserves worship. When it comes to the asma and sifat, the names and attributes of Allah, you will find the Muslims in many different sects and many different deviations. They will vary, and this book is, all of this book is to deal just with that. To remove the misconception from your mind, so you will understand who Allah is according to what Allah said in the Quran, according to what the Prophet ﷺ described Allah with in the Sunnah, and according to the understanding of the companions and the first three generations of Muslims. Very fundamental. Because not everybody could read and understand properly. But it was those who were closer to the Prophet ﷺ, who were with him, who could have asked him. But there were things that they never asked about because they understood them. So then the people wanted to go into detail, trying to explain things about Allah that they don't need to go there. And they started speaking about Allah with that knowledge, and they started denying the attributes of Allah, or adding comparing Him to His creation. Why? Because there were things that were mentioned that the Sahaba never questioned about. Like, Ar-Rahmanu ala al-Arsh istawa, thumma istawa al-Arsh. Allah rose above the throne. All you need to do is know that Allah rose above the throne. You don't need to think how, you don't need to imagine the method, and you have no idea what it is like. Why? There's nothing like Allah. Nothing. You cannot, possibly. But the innovators could not be satisfied. That's why one of them came to Imam Malik. You know Imam Malik, Imam Darul Hijra, one of the four a'imma that are followed. And he was given a class in the masjid, and a man came to him, he said, كيف استوى الله على العرش؟ كيف استوى الرحمن العرش؟ How did Allah rise above His throne? So Imam Malik, from the severity of the question, he put his head down and started sweating. They seen sweat started to form on his forehead. Then he raised his head and he said, Al-Istiwa'u Ma'loom. The word Istiwa, which is rising above, is known in the Arabic language. We know what it means. It is resting above something, rising above something. This is what Istiwa means in Arabic. Wal-Kayfu Majhool. How is unknown. وَالْإِيمَانُ بِهِ وَاجِبٌ. And for you to believe in it is an obligation, it's compulsory, because Allah said it in the Quran, وَالسُؤَالُ عَنْهُ بِدْعَةٌ. And to ask about it is an innovation. And I see you as nothing but an innovator, and he commanded that he will be thrown out of the masjid. Because he came to ruin the minds of the people. People were fine to believe Allah is above His throne, done deal. Close the door. You want to open it and say how and not how, you're going to fall into things that you should not be discussing. Because Allah taught us principle, لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ. There is nothing like Allah. لم يكن له كفوا أحد. There is no equal to Allah. And all the verses that we will be dealing with in this book, inshallah. عز وجل. طيب. هذا هو الذي كثر فيه الخوض. فانقسم الناس فيه إلى ثلاثة أقسام. وهم ممثل ومعطل ومعتدل. والمعطل إما مكذب أو محرف. He says this is where the dispute arose between the Muslims. And the people are divided into three categories regarding the names and attributes of Allah, if you want to write that down. The people are divided into three categories regarding the names and attributes of Allah. Number one, ممثل. ممثل is someone who makes Allah's names and attributes similar to His creation. Compares Allah to His creation. Okay? ممثل.